Now then, today in the box is the Temtop M10 air quality monitor. Now let's give it a go, but first be sure to check my full review below and to press like and subscribe. Now many thanks, and let's get on with it. Let's look inside the box, and here's the monitor itself, which is made from plastic and fairly lightweight, but it feels nevertheless well made and it's got a quality feel to it. Now there's the reset key. There's a small hole in the back that he used to reset it with. There's the power cable, which is the standard micro USB. And there's the rather small but well-written user guide. When we look at it in more detail, there's not really a great deal to see. On the top you see the one and only button. On the back you can see the charging port, which next to it the tiny reset aperture. And like I say, it all feels well made and built to last. And when we press the button on the top, we can scroll through the various monitoring modes, starting off with air quality index, which is a general overview of the air quality. Then we've got TVOC, which is looking for a range of chemicals in the air. Then we've got HCHO, which is monitoring formaldehyde levels in the air, and that's rather nasty stuff. And finally, we've got PM2.5, which is looking for tiny dust particles or other particulates in the air. And now we're back to AQI. I needed a simple and easy to use monitor that will sit in the living room and keep me updated on the state of the air in the room. And this compact size 73-pound device from Temtop, well, that seemed to fit the bill. It's lightweight and made entirely from plastic, but nevertheless it feels well made with a quality feel to it. It's got a clear and easy to read display on the front. Press the button on the top to scroll through PM2.5, HCHO, TVOC and AQI readings, and these are all in real time. And there's a single LED on the top which changes colour to indicate the current alert level. But I'll go into all this in more detail in the written review below. But as regards to readings, you really don't need to start worrying until the LED turns red. Now there are three different versions of this meter. This one, which is the M10, the Wi-Fi and app supported M10i, and the less well specified but slightly cheaper P10. Now this monitor is designed for home use and is USB powered, but it's got a built-in rechargeable battery, which is good for about 6 hours of use. And that's enough for you to move it from room to room to test the level in the different rooms. But bear in mind, the meter needs to sit for half an hour or so to accustom itself to the atmosphere in each new location. So this is a nice little meter that just sits there and gets the job done without making a lot of fuss about it. And there's no complicated calibration needed, but there is a reset button on the back, which I never needed to use. So I think for the price, it's a pretty decent buy. Although with hindsight, perhaps I wish I paid the extra £25 to get the Wi-Fi version. But nevertheless, this I think is still a pretty decent buy.